What's up, y'all? This is Scott Davis, and my goal today is to make calculating customer lifetime value accessible and maybe even enjoyable for you. I'll refer to customer lifetime value by its abbreviation, CLV, throughout this video. Let's dig in. First, why is CLV even important? Well, CLV gets at the heart of marketing's objective to attract and keep profitable customers. You need to understand CLV to put together effective marketing plans and make strategic decisions. How much money are you going to allocate to attract new customers and generate leads? Attracting new customers might cost 3 or 4 times as much as retaining existing ones. CLV will help you understand what kind of return to expect on today's investments in customer acquisition and retention. How are you going to stop customers from defecting? What aspects of customer attrition are controllable and which are not? An average company loses 10% of its customers each year. A better understanding of CLV will help you manage these dynamics. Think of managing customers as managing a leaky bucket. Your customers are represented by water, and the water already inside the bucket is your customer base. New customers added to the bucket increase your customer base. But there's also a hole near the bottom of the bucket, and the water leaking out represents lost customers. So in order to grow, your business needs to increase the flow into the bucket by acquiring new customers, or decrease the customer outflow by retaining your existing customers, or both. It's also important to note that not all customers are profitable. Have you heard of the 80-20 rule? 80% of company profits come from 20% of its customers. Given our fight against the leaky bucket and mixed profitability amongst customers, we need a better understanding of customer profitability in the long term. Enter customer lifetime value. CLV is calculated a number of different ways, but let's focus on the common features. We start with the top line, the company's expected revenues or sales in dollars over the customer's lifetime. We are interested in profit, so we also need to subtract the expected costs, including acquisition, sales, and service costs for the customer. Have you ever watched the TV show Shark Tank? Notice that the investor's financial questions usually relate to the variables used in computing CLV. It's not that easy to compute, but you can do it. Here comes some math. Let's start with the most basic formula for CLV. CLV equals the annual profit contribution per customer times the average number of years they remain a customer minus the initial cost of acquiring a customer. Now, profit contribution is the margin, or the amount of the sale that is not eaten up by variable costs. Other CLV formulas account for fixed costs and the time value of money, but we're going to start slow. Let's walk through an example with our basic formula. Suppose the average Starbucks customer spends $6 per visit and visits 200 times per year. That is $1,200 in annual revenue per customer. But the contribution margin is only $3 per transaction because of all the variable costs that go into making a cup of coffee. So the annual profit contribution per customer is $600. We multiply the $600 times the average number of years someone remains a customer at Starbucks. Suppose in our case, it's 20 years. We now have 600 times 20 for $12,000. But it costs money to acquire new customers, say $5,000 on average per customer for Starbucks. We subtract that from our $12,000 to arrive at a $7,000 customer lifetime value. This number is going to help us figure out how much to pay to acquire and retain customers. Beyond that, we can see how important it is to sell more to our existing customers. Can we push the $6 per transaction higher? Could we stretch 20 years of loyalty to 25? How much will that cut into our contribution margin? We could also take a more nuanced view and look at the impact of low and high profit customers. Did you know that different methods for attracting customers have different CLVs? For example, acquiring customers through deep discounting can substantially reduce CLV. You need to be thinking about how much potential your new customers have to become loyal to your business. Understanding CLV will help you set and evaluate pricing and promotion strategies. This concludes our first look at customer lifetime value. If you liked this video, please consider subscribing, liking, and commenting. Thank you.